Welcome back to WagerTalk.com. College football Saturday. It's conference championship weekend, and we've got a big one in the Pac-12. We've got USC and Stanford. Brian, this is a rematch from earlier in the season. Stanford went into USC as a 9.5-point underdog, won the game by 10. But if you looked at the game, and I covered up the score and just showed you the box score and showed you the statistics, yardage-wise, this was only a 50-yard difference yardage, but yet Stanford won by 10. The difference in the game, they ran 13 more plays than USC did. Nobody had any turnovers, but they were able to dominate on the ground, keep the ball away from that high-octane USC offense.
Yeah, and that's what they're going to have to do here again. The USC defense is coming on also. But, you know, first off, this is a neutral field, but it's very close to Stanford. So I gave Stanford a 1.5-point home field advantage here. And as you mentioned, they upset USC. So you would think USC has a slight advantage here. And if you look, USC's 4-2 down the stretch. They're playing good ball after they got rid of the coach. Their losses were at Oregon and at Notre Dame. I mean, you can't fault them for either one of those.
No, in the Notre Dame game, they actually were in that game. And if you remember, that was just a really bad week for them because they fired Sarkisian late, you know, after they lost that weekend. So they had to go, you know, midweek, you know, you're playing a game. A lot of times if a coach gets fired midseason, they might wait till a bye week so the new coach has, you know, an extra week to prepare. So to play one of your biggest rivals, Notre Dame, and a very good Notre Dame team on the road with everything that was going on, it was a tough week. And they had every opportunity to win that ball game. They had a punt block for a touchdown, a couple late interceptions cost them. Yes, I was on USC in that game. I remember it well. But the Oregon game, they just ran into a team that really, you talk about a team that it's a shame they started out slow because they were playing the best football in the Pac-12 at the end of the season, no question.
It just tells you when you get a quality quarterback, obviously he went out with injury, but when he came back, they were a totally different team.
Absolutely. Do you think, you know, the revenge angle here, you know, a lot of people love to talk about revenge and, you know, me being a situational handicapper, we always look at that. What I look at is what is different from the last time they played. And what's different is this team seems to be playing more cohesive and they're playing a little more. If you look at the run-pass split, since Helton took over, they're running the football a little more than they're passing it, which I think is making the passing game even better. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, and obviously the coach is the big difference. But when you go to more of a running game, I think that helps them here against Stanford. I'm really torn on this game because I'd like to play USC, but as I just mentioned, they haven't done well against teams when they step up in class. They lost to Stanford earlier, lost to Notre Dame, and then also lost the other game to Oregon. They did win last week against crosstown rival UCLA. I think still the line is a little high. I expected it to come out around 3, and we're seeing a little bit higher than that right now. So I'm leaning with USC. Haven't got there yet, but I'm looking at it.
Yeah, I got to agree with you. This is one that I've been back and forth with, but USC in the revenge spot, the fact that it is a different attitude with this team, and they were impressed with what Helton did, you know, as the interim basis that they went ahead and offered him the contract. So, you know, he's the coach for the future, which I think is good to do it now instead of doing it, you know, after the bowls or right before the bowl game. You know, get it there, let these kids know he's there. Because if you remember the last time, you know, they had Ed Orgeron, which I thought they should have kept.
I agree.
And they didn't, and they went the route that they did. So they're staying in-house this time. I think they can get it done here. I like that they're running the football. In years past, Stanford was the physical team of the Pac-12. If you look this year, they're not playing that physical style that
especially
they used
defensively.
To. Yeah, and I think that USC can trade points with them. I'll take whatever points are available here. I think it's a little bit high, too, from the first meeting, you know, from going from a 9.5-point favorite that USC was, even though we're switching, you know, we're going to a, let's call it home neutral for, for Stanford. I still think it's too much in the switch.
Yeah, UCLA was a little bit overrated early on in the season. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a lot of points in this game because I don't think either team's going to slow down the opposite. Thing is, how you know, obviously when you run the football, you take more time off the clock, but I think it'll be a high-scoring shootout.
Yeah, but if you're running the ball effectively, you're stopping the clock on first downs a lot,
there
too.
You go.
So, all right, here we go. Me and Brian both have a weak vote for you right now on USC plus the points. And guys, special deal for you this week. You can take $10 off any package when you enter it at checkout. Use coupon code FRANK and the number 10, Frank, the number 10, you'll get $10 off any package this week, and you can use that on the $69 all-access package, which is absolutely the best deal in sports. Get Thursday through Monday, all plays, football, basketball, $69 only at wagertalk.com. Be sure to check out all of our other videos available this week at wagertalk.com.